Today, I'm at the Porsche Experience Center Hockenheimring, attempting to beat a world record. That record is drifting an electric vehicle using Porsche's fantastic Taycan, but this time in two-wheel drive guys. Now, Guinness has said we need to do 2.5 kilometers around a wetted steering pad to get a record, and I think that's going to be tough enough. So I'm aiming, I think, to do 16 laps or more of the steering pad here. Let's see what happens.
But before we think about setting any record, job one is to understand the car and the circuit we'll be using.
You can go until the car doesn't move anymore.
Okay, because I always told that would damage an EV, but it doesn't.
No, it doesn't. Okay. The battery's gonna protect itself.
Okay.
The AC is gonna be off. This one's gonna be off, head-up display is gonna be off, but the instrument cluster obviously is gonna stay.
Cool.
But other than that, it's a regular Taycan.
It is a regular Taycan. Okay.
It's time for a guided tour with Porsche driving experience coach Dennis, and then it'll be my turn to have a practice.
Let's see how that goes then, right?
Go on.
Right. To go off the power, then just get it into a drift. What I basically do is try to use a lot of the steering. So a steer bit to the inside, the back end will come. And this is actually the most efficient angle, like quite big, because you don't use so much power. You just need to use a little bit of power. Do a lot with the steering.
Yeah.
If the angle is getting a bit less, I steer to the inside and you feel the back end is coming.
Well, this is going to be interesting for an hour with no aircon.
Steering wheel to get it sideways instead of the throttle.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Yeah.
To activate the steering, not the throttle,
yes.
But it's counterintuitive to me.
Exactly.
It's absolutely ridiculous idea. I love it. But what's incredible, without sounding like someone from the PR department, is the throttle mapping. It's so intuitive. You know, the best thing I can say about it is I haven't thought about the throttle pedal at all. Is it a throttle pedal? I don't know what you call it anymore. That bit. It's just when you come off the throttle, the car comes back into line. When you go on, you get more oversteer. It's absolutely intuitive. It's a drift weapon. It's an electric drift weapon.
Yeah.
What have you made?
Yeah.
I want one.
I'm amazed how quickly he picked up a feeling for the car. I mean, we did like I don't know, 50 laps, 60 laps, something like that. And it's just amazing how easy he feels behind the steering wheel.
It was the first time for him on an electric car drifting like this, and he felt also comfortable, and especially like the beginning was doing well, trying to be more efficient with the steering, and he picked up this really well. So I'm looking forward to the afternoon.
This isn't going to be easy. I'm going to have to drive in a continuous circle whilst not depositing my breakfast on the Taycan's dashboard. And there's quite a lot of stuff in place to attempt a world record. First of all, you need a two-wheel drive electric car. Thank you, Porsche. You also need the circuit. Again, thank you, Porsche. And you also need to be able to verify the record attempt. This means accurate surveying of the circuit and a lot of tech to make sure the car is actually drifting.
For this event, we used the VBOX 3i SL, the two antenna system, where we are able to measure the drift angle from the car. We use that in combination with the wheel speed so that we can calculate exactly the time and the distance the car was driven during the drift.
Finally, you need a Guinness official to adjudicate the record and an expert eyewitness to make sure everything is above board.
My job here today is to ensure that a record was achieved by verifying all of the evidence collected and checking the measurements taken by the surveyors. Denise Ritzman is here as my vehicle and drifting expert to confirm how many of those laps were actually in drift.
There are many difficult things on this. Like first, that is an electric car. If you go on the throttle, you have like full torque there, full torque away. And to find there the middle, because you need to stay on the throttle on the same position as you are. I think to go like more than 1 hour around one corner and one sideways, yeah, you can get a little bit ill.
Now, the rules state that I'm only allowed 3 attempts to break the record. No pressure then.
So this is my shot at EV glory. I'm ready to go. Car's all ready. Traction control is off. I've got the long throttle position. My seated position is right. Just got to wait for the official from Guinness to give the okay. And then I'm probably going to make a fool of myself.
So we're normal and we're in drive and we're about to attempt a new electric car drifting record, whatever that means. Let's give it a go. Throttle is very sensitive, so you have to basically try and agitate it with the steering, otherwise you use too much gas, or is it electricity, I don't know. But this really is a new concept, isn't it? A fully sideways electric car. It's basically a 4S with the front motor taken out of it. I feel quite queasy already, if I'm honest with you. We're getting quite hot now. It's actually quite disorientating. I don't actually know where I am on the circle at times. The amount of arm work is surprising. Sorry, guys.
Best, man.
I'm now getting this with the light come down there. This is just silver,
right?
So you can't see. I'm looking up, I'm looking. How many laps was that? 15?
No,
checking the footage to see whether we have actually beaten the record or not. Because if they have, it takes the pressure off for this last run. But I have to say, I can't see myself doing 45 minutes in there. I was properly nauseous on that last run. I can't find a horizon point where I'm comfortable. If I look too low, I lose where I am. And if I look too high, I start to feel sick. These guys have been doing it for a while. They must have iron guts. I thought my guts were quite good.
So attempt one and I was two laps short of a new record. Very frustrating, especially as I had a suspicion my stomach wasn't going to handle much more. The only thing to do is to jump back in and have another go.
This is much trickier than any steering pad I've driven on before. It's changing the whole time. I quite want this to be over now. I feel dead sick. Throttle. F*** it. Don't know how many that was. That's my lot though. Right, I lost count, but I'm praying that was more than 16 laps. That's all I had to give.
I can confirm you completed 18 laps in continuous drift, which means you've set a new Guinness World Records title at 3.3 kilometres for the longest vehicle in drift for an electric car. You're officially amazing. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Now, I'll let you into a secret here. I am but the apprentice. The sorcerer is a guy called Dennis. He works here. Watch this. Come on, Dennis, show us how it's done, boss.
I'll do my best.
Dennis, the boss.
Thank you. Such a wonderful car, really. Enjoying it so much. 79%, 79.
Copy that, 79.
Looks a bit stupid, just steering with one hand. But I noticed if it's just one direction with the circle, spending long time in the car, well, hopefully I don't make a mistake. It's for me a bit easier to just use one hand, being more precise, because the car reacts really precise. If I steer a bit more to the inside, the back end will come a lot more, which helps me to be as efficient as possible. Of course, have a try to aim for a really good result here. So nice. I just saw that my colleagues from Porsche Germany just arrived, please support me. That's so kind of them. But again, more pressure for me. I try to stay focused. Wow, it was almost a mistake, almost out of the drift. Stay focused, Dennis. Right, so the battery shows me 0 kilometer. It will stop at one point, I guess. Another warning. Okay, no power.
Ja, wir haben uns da gerade drüber gehalten. Kannst reinkommen, alles cool. Super cool. Herzlichen Glückwunsch.
Danke, was war der Zeit? Das ist viel wichtiger für mich. So I need to know the time. No battery power anymore. Thank you very much, Chris, for giving me the chance. Thank you very much, Porsche. Porsche Experience and Hoonicorn. Thank you very much. I really enjoyed it. Und was war der Zeit?
Richtig geil.
Richtig geil.
54. Ah, letztes Mal war besser. Also, vielen Dank.
Sehr gut.
Danke euch.
Mega, richtig geil.
Danke, super. It was amazing. First of all, for me getting this chance to do it, and I enjoyed every lap, I should say, because I just heard there were quite a few laps. So really, I enjoyed every lap I did around here without the AC. I have to say, the temperatures were not that bad now. It's a little bit later than, because it's around 5 o'clock we started, so it was not too bad actually with the temperature, and I really enjoyed doing the laps.
Big congratulations to Dennis then. He made it look so easy, but I can assure you it wasn't. And I can also assure you my attempt would have been no better had I gone anti-clockwise. So Dennis is the new record holder. I'm just wondering if I've set a new record for holding a world record for the shortest amount of time.
Any tips you could give to Chris to maybe got more laps out?
Well, first of all, go to bed early. Don't pick a flight in the middle of the night, yeah? Second of all, get used to a left-hand driven car. Third of all, never go clockwise. Always go anti-clockwise.